Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use Discord.js to create a help command for your Discord bot. In the video description will be a GitHub repository. From that, you can clone all the progress I've made so far, or you can just write down this code. We will also be using this basic command handler. So with that said, I'm going to start things off by importing that command handler into our main file here. So constant command equals require command. And then we're going to create a new command handler. So we're going to pass in the client and the actual command we want, which is help. And then we're going to get a callback, and that'll be the message object. Now, just to make sure everything's working, we could do message.channel.send coming soon. If we save this and go into our terminal, if we run node index.js, this will start our bot. Going into Discord, we can run exclamation point help, and it says coming soon. So far, everything's working. We can delete these messages, and going back, we then want to send a much more meaningful message. So we can use backticks, and we're going to send a message here. And let's say that we have a math bot where we can use exclamation point help, and then we can say displays the help menu, and then exclamation point add num1, num2. Adds two numbers, exclamation point sub num1, num2, subtracts two numbers. So this is obviously something that you would be implementing depending on your bot's functionality, but you can display a few commands here. We grab these inside of double stars, so it's going to be bold. Obviously, this is optional. And you can format this however you want, and you'd want to be able to add whatever commands you want, obviously. But if we now save this, let's actually send another message here at the top here. We can say, these are my supported commands. So now if we restart our bot, we go back to Discord, exclamation point help. We see these are my supported commands. And so obviously the add and the sub don't actually exist, but you'd add whatever commands that you would have. Now, another thing that is common is that the bot would have a status that would say to use exclamation point help, and so we can set that up. So in order to do that, we need to get access to the prefix, which is inside of the configuration file. So we can say const prefix. We're going to destructure that from config. To make sure this works, we can console log the prefix like this. If we save this and we reset our bot, we can then go back into Discord, run exclamation point help, and we see actually, we didn't need to run that, but we see prefix is exclamation points, and so we know that that is working. You can go ahead and delete these messages real quick just to clean up this channel. Now going back, now that we had the prefix, we can say client.user.setPresence. We're going to pass in an activity, and this will have an object that will have a name property. And for this, we can say use exclamation point help. However, we don't want to specifically hard code in the exclamation point. We want to use a string literal here, or a template literal rather. We're going to pass in the prefix into this. So if your prefix is double exclamation point or left bracket or whatever it might be, that's going to show that instead of just exclamation point. So if we save this and we restart our bot, now we see the status says use exclamation point help. Now we can make this a little bit more clear. We can put this inside of quotes and we can get rid of the use. So if we save this and we restart our bot again, we now see exclamation point help for help. And if we run that command, we then get our custom help menu. Now, in the last couple of videos, which I will have linked in the description, along with the playlist for all of my Discord.js videos, we've used embeds. And so that is another way you can display a help menu in a more meaningful or more visually appealing way. However, I've already covered that in multiple other videos, so I will not be covering it here. But keep in mind that that is an option. So that is how you're going to create a very basic help command and actually display how to use that help command whenever people are using your bot if they look at the top right. One last thing is that if I were to run a command, like let's say I'm expecting slash mult to be a thing for multiplying and we want to multiply two numbers. If I were to run this, you might want to have that say unknown command. Maybe you want to prompt them to use exclamation point help, or you might want to just send the help menu right there and tag the user. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, Feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.